Well, holy smokes, guys, don't put your kids to beds. Don't hide your wives. This is not a Call of Duty 2020 trailer. But let me tell you, okay, I am definitely sus about this one. The fact that Treyarch is uploading back-to-back, they uploaded back-to-back. This is the second video. And this will open up your third eye in a little bit because, of course, the leaks are saying Treyarch, Raven, and Sledgehammer are working on Call of Duty 2020, but officially that is not yet confirmed. And the fact that Treyarch is being active, and this is one of those images, right? Like, this is from the video. Of course, I'm gonna be playing the whole video they uploaded. This is pretty suspicious. You will understand, you will see the point. This is not a Call of Duty 2020 trailer, but this is for Call of Duty 2020. And I'm actually excited. I don't know why I'm excited though, but Skibby actually at me in the situation. Now, the scientists are baffled, right? Says that, hey man, is this Call of Duty 2020? And I responded, I think it is World at W. Of course, I cannot say certain words on YouTube. Smash the like button for YouTube, mate. But I don't remember this mission being at nighttime, though. Then Ryan B fired back and said that I don't remember the HUD being like that in World at W. You know, facts. Robert came out and said that this might be the Paris level from Call of Duty World W2, right? WW2. And I think that's what's up. Now, here's the thing, man. If this is really true, you gotta understand, this video is Treyarch's video, and you will see a lot of Treyarch games in here, but the fact that, and if it's true, I'm not sure this is true, that's why I need detectives, that's why I need all of you scientists on this case immediately, but if this is really from Call of Duty WW2, you know that's a Sledgehammer Games. Leak said that Treyarch and Sledgehammer Games are working together, so I am definitely sus about it. But anyways, guys, let's check out the video out. It's 2 minutes and 44 seconds long, it's a pretty good video, I am really excited for it. If you're new, I cover all the big gaming news and Call of Duty stuff, so if a channel like you is into that, then subscribe. We're on the road to 150,000 subscribers, and every little bit helps, guys. So definitely
with those
like
challenges
and
where
subscribe.
It's something
check
that
it out.
Isn't really real. Those challenges where it's something that isn't really real, but I need to make it look real, comes a need for flexibility, for adaptability, and the freedom to fail. The freedom to fail forward.
The difference working at Treyarch, it's obviously Call of Duty is very high profile, so there's always the need to do better and better.
Call of Duty 2020,
boys. There's constant improvement, which as an artist, you know, you do want to constantly improve. So being in an environment where that's expected helps push you forward.
People that take initiative to do that on their own, they're going to find a lot of success here.
I think we stay competitive and we stay in front of the technological curve. Partially because there's a high expectation bar. We have a lot of really, really clever engineers and tech people in this building, and we don't really leave a lot of stones unturned.
Black Ops 1 was a stone unturned.
Challenge daily by the
test. Yeah, that one right here.
And what's cool is that not just my peers, but my manager, my lead, and even the studio heads, they encourage us and encourage me to try different ways of getting to the goal.
Because the people here inspire you to raise the bar. It pushed me to broaden my own horizons, to raise my own skill levels. It's a team effort, and that's what you need in order to not only succeed, but to make amazing games. And
my man's humble.
Expectations for proficiency is definitely very high. I think it's really important to recognize that Treyarch is the opportunity where, as an artist, you will find challenges like nowhere else. And you'll find support nowhere else. It's a place where you can find a lot of opportunities, a lot of responsibilities can be given to you. You can grow within it. And at the end of the day, the games we make, they're state of the art.
People are
now,
really
I need to pause it for a second, okay? Here's the thing, okay? The fact that this is a new video, right? This is a new video for sure. They're talking about, they're like, hey guys, like, hey, we're in this Roni Rona situation without actually saying it, right? This is kind of suspect, dog, because this is a new video. And of course, we're hearing bad news that this game might be delayed, and the evidence supports it, right? Because we haven't seen any trailer yet. Like, where's the trailer, right? No trailer. So maybe it's gonna be delayed, but or maybe not. I hope it's not delayed, but if the game isn't finished, then for sure delayed and drop Modern Warfare 2 Remastered multiplayer. But the fact that this is a new video they uploaded and they have shot it in the studio. Are they really working from studios? Because David Wonderheart said that he's working on the Black Ops franchise on his LinkedIn profile from home. What I think is happening here is that some of the devs are actually at the studios and other devs are working from home. I think that's what's happening. So, like, they don't catch the Roni. I think that's what's happening. Let me know your thoughts below, right? So this might not be that bad, but the bad sign is that there's no trailer so far and they're hiring for more people. Hiring for more people is actually a good sign, but a bad sign. Bad sign because there's no trailer, right? Good sign, hey, they're actually broadening and they are like looking for more people to finish this game and make it hopefully better. So that's like my viewpoint right now on the situation. Let me know your thoughts below and let's continue.
Listen to constructive feedback and implement it into the next iteration of whatever it is they're working on.
I really hope they hear that skill based matchmaking part and remove it, man. All my homies hate it.
Oh wow, this is a whole new level. I'm Mike Chubb. I'm a senior visual effects artist here at Treyarch. I've been here for 8 years.
Yuri Nedelin.
8 years.
I'm a lead artist, and I've been at Treyarch for a little bit over a year.
Caleb Turner. I'm a senior weapons artist here at Treyarch, and I've been here for 10 plus years.
My name is Scott Wells. I'm a senior character artist here at Treyarch, and I've been here about 12 and a half years.
Brian John Anderson. I'm the technical art director, and I've been at Treyarch for 17 years.
17 years. Dude, that's crazy. I don't know why I'm excited, dude. Like, I really don't want to be... This is a Call of Duty cycle, man. This is a Call of Duty cycle. I don't like it, man. I don't like it. I don't want to be excited, bro. Let me know your opinions below. Let me know your thoughts below. And if you're new here, I will definitely keep you guys on the loops with all the big gaming news. PS5, Xbox, GTA 6, Call of Duty. Literally all the big gaming news, right? And Call of Duty is a priority. If you're into it, then subscribe. Check out our video on the screen. And I will see you right there. Peace out, stud muffins.